Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss on APRO-JRD. This lesson is written by Sudha Murte. So let's see about her, about the author. Sudha Murte was born on 1950, is an Indian technologist, philanthropist and writer. She was born in Karnataka and studied computer science and engineering at the Indian Institute of Science. She was academically brilliant and was a gold medalist at both the graduate and postgraduate levels. She began her career with telco and in 1981 founded Infosys with her husband Narayana Murthy. Infosys is the second largest IT services company in India today and is a household name. In 1996, Murthy started Infosys Foundation, a non-profit organization which supports programs in the fields of healthcare, rural development, education and art. She began writing in the later years of her life, documenting her varied experiences as a woman in the then nascent IT industry, in social work and as a teacher. She is a prolific writer in both Kannada and English and has published novels, short story collections, essays and travelogues, besides columns in newspapers. Her well-known works include How I Taught My Grandmother to Read and Other Stories, second one, The Old Man and His God, Discovering the Spirit of India, third one, The Magic Drum and Other Favorite Stories, The Day I Stopped Drinking Milk, Life Stories from Here and There, and Grandma's Bag of Stories. About the text, in this essay, she reminisces about J.R.D. Tata, who gave her the first break in her career as an engineer. She talks of great men, simplicity and vision, and how he influenced her own journey as an entrepreneur and philanthropist. This is a very important topic of her, as we discuss in about herself and about the text. She had taken experiences from various companies, especially she wants to express herself about experience of JRD. Let's see. There are two photographs that hang on my office wall. Every day when I enter my office, I look at them before starting my day. They are pictures of two old people, one of gentleman in a blue suit and the other a black white image of a man with dreamy eyes and a white beard. People have asked me if the people in the photographs are related to me. Some have even asked me, is this black and white photo then of a Sufi saint or a religious guru? I smile and reply, no, nor are they related to me. These people made an impact on my life. I am grateful to them. Students, look at here. Sudha Murthy has been discussing on the impression or as an ideal person. Everyone has own ideal person in their own life. So, let's see. People have asked me if the people in the photographs are related to me. Some have even asked me, is this black and white photo that of a Sufi saint or religious guru? I smile and reply, no, nor are they related to me. These people made an impact on my life. I am grateful to them. Who are they? The man in the blue suit is Bharat Ratna, J.R.D. Tata, and the black and white photo is of Jamshedji Tata. Here she is talking about two great personalities. One is Bharat Ratna, J.R.D. Tata, and the black and white photo is of Jamshedji Tata. But why do you have them in your office? You can call it gratitude. then invariably I have to tell the person of following story. Right now, she is narrating story which occurred with her. Let's see. It was a long time ago. I was young, bright, bold and idealistic. I was in the final year of my master's course in computer science at the Indian Institute of Science, ISC, in Bengaluru, then known as the Tata Institute. Life was full of fun and joy. I did not know what helpless or injustice meant. It was probably the April of 1974. Bengaluru was getting warm and red gulmohars were blooming at ISC campus. I was only girl in my postgraduate department and was staying at the ladies hostel. Friends, look at it was a time when did Sudhamurthy take her education in Bengaluru in ISC. Now we are very lucky and we found everywhere girls are taking admission in everywhere, but it was the time when Sudhamurthy was taking her education at Indian Institute of Science. She was the only lady in that batch. She mentioned she was very full of fun and enjoy and all the things. Let's see. It was probably the April of 1974. Bengaluru was getting warm and red gulmohars were blooming at the ISC campus. I was the only girl in my postgraduate department and was staying at the ladies' hostel. Other girls were pursuing research in different departments of science. I was looking forward to going abroad to complete the doctorate in computer science. I had been offered scholarship from university in USA. I had not thought of taking of a job in India. This is description about her experience when she was taking her education at ISC Bengaluru. Right now, she is talking about her own experience with JRD. Let's see. One day, while on the way to my hostel from our lecture hall complex, I saw an advertisement on the notice board. It was standard job recruitment notice from the famous automobile company Telco, now Tata Motors. Before Tata, it is known as Telco Company. It stated that company had excellent academic background, etc. At the bottom was a small line, lady candidates need not apply. I repeat, lady candidates need not apply. I read it and was very upset. For the first time in my life, I was against gender discrimination. Now, she is talking about the advertisement which is placed at notice board and it was the job opportunity to her. But there was a notice or there is a note. Lady will not accept or lady will not allow to apply for this job. Let's see what happened with her. Though I was not keen on taking up a job, I saw this as a challenge. I had done extremely well in academics, better than most of my male peers. I repeat, I had done extremely well in academics, better than most of my male peers. Little did I know then that in a real academic excellence is not enough to be a successful. It is a gender discrimination had taken place with Sudhamurthy. Let's see what she had taken action against it. After reading the notice, I went fuming to my room. I decided to inform the topmost person in Telco's management about injustice the company was perpetrating. I got postcard and started to write, but there was a problem. I did not know who headed Telco. I thought it must be one of the Tatas. I knew JRD Tata was the head of the Tata Group. I had been his pictures in newspapers. Actually, Sumant Malgaonkar was the company's chairman then. I took card, addressed it to JRD and started writing. To this day, I remember clearly what I wrote. I quote here, the great Tatas have always been pioneers. They are the people who started the basic infrastructures industries in India, such as iron and steel, chemicals, textiles and locomotives. They have carved for higher education in India since 1900, and they were responsible for the establishment of the Indian Institute of Science. Fortunately, I studied there, but I am surprised how a company such a telco is discriminating on the basis of the gender, unquote. This is whatever he had written to the JRD. Let's see again. I posted the letter and forgot about it. Less than 10 days later, I received a telegram stating that I had to appear for an interview at Telco's Pune facility at the company's expense. I was taken aback by the telegram. My hostel mates told me I should use the opportunity to go Pune free of cost and buy them the famous Pune saris for cheap. I collected rupees 30 each from everyone who wanted a sari. When I look back, I feel like laughing at the reasons for my going, but back then they seemed to go enough to make the trip. It was my first visit to Pune and I immediately fell in love with the city. To this day, it remains dear to me. I feel as much home in. This is all about the letter. She had got an opportunity to appear an interview at Telco company in Pune. This is a little bit about it. Let's see another part in another video.